Good morning. I am Arul Kumar, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, GCE Bargur. Today we are going to discuss about Vernum cipher. So Vernum cipher is a technique to convert the given plain text into cipher text. So you can provide secure transmission of any message from one place to another using this Vernum cipher. So what is meant by encryption? What is meant by encryption? Encryption is a process to convert any message into non-readable format. So let your plain text is I have to transmit this message from one place to another in a secure manner. In that case, you can apply this encryption and decryption process. So here, we are going to discuss about this Vernum cipher. How to make use of this Vernum cipher to perform encryption and decryption process. So in the case of Vernum cipher, what we have to do is, we need to assign some numerals to the various letters involved in alphabets. So you all know that we are having 26 letters starting from A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, L, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, So what we need to do is, first we need to assign some numerals to all alphabets. So here what I am doing is, I am assigning 0 to letter A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So this is the first step we need to follow to do encryption of any plain text using Vernum cipher. So after assigning the numerals to the various alphabets, what we have to do is, we have to choose our key. So we need to ensure that the length of the key must be same as the length of the plain text. See here, the length of plain text is here 3. The length of plain text is 3. Here the length is. So what you have to do is, we have to choose our key so that its length must be equal to the length of plain text. So here I am going to choose my key list like this. Say we A, B, so this is my key. So here you see here the length of the key is also. So therefore we can able to do encryption of the given plain text using Vernum cipher. The first thing is, you will assign the numerals to alphabets. Second thing is, we need to choose our key such a way that its length must be equal to length of plain text. Next, what we have to do is, we need to consider the numerals which we assign to the alphabets. See here, what is the numeral we assign to letter H? Is 7. Here it is 7, right? For A, is 0. For I, this 8. Likewise, we need to consider the numerals to the various letters of key also. A is 0, for B it is 1, again. So after assigning numerals to each letter of plain text and key, to do encryption, what we have to do is, we need to add the corresponding numerals. Now, after adding, What do you get? So 7 plus 0 is 7. 0 plus 1 is 1. 8 plus 1 it is 8 plus 1. Now we need to consider the letter for female 7 and 1 and 9 to get the cipher text. What is the letter for the numeral 7? It is H. It is H. For 1, it is B. For 9, it is H. So, whenever we are transmitting your paint test high using Vernum cipher, what we are doing is we are converting this paint test into cipher text. HBG. So instead of transmitting hat to some place using Vernum cipher, what actually we are doing is we are transmitting HBJ to that place. So this is nothing but encryption process. You see here the plain test, it is in readable format. It is in readable format. But your cipher text is in non-readable format. So another expression cannot able to understand what kind of message is exchanged between two persons. Right? This is the way to do encryption using Vernum cipher. Now, in order to get back the actual message which is being transferred from one place to another, what we have to do is we need to apply decryption. In decryption, what we have to do is the same. Generally, decryption is the reverse process of encryption. So, whatever process you followed in encryption, same thing should be done in reverse manner in the case of decryption to get back the actual message which is transferred from one place to another. Now, to do decryption, what we have to do? To do decryption, what we have to do? So, this is my plain text. It is high. This is my key, that is A, B, B. My cipher text is
HBG.
HBG. Now, to do decryption, what we have to do is to do decryption. Again, you consider the numerals. For various letters of ciphertext as well as key. For key, what is the numeral you are saying? It is 0, is 1. For hex, what is the number? It's A, B, C, D, E, F, G. H, right? For H, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Therefore, the numerals for letter H is 7. So, I am considering that number, that is 7. For B, it is 1. For J, 9, right? J is 9. So, likewise, we need to consider the numerals for various letters involved in ciphertext as well as key. So to do decryption, what you have to do is, already I told you, decryption is the inverse or reverse process of encryption. And encryption, using Vernum cipher, what we have done, we have summed, we have added the numerals of ciphertext with respect to the corresponding numerals of letters involved in the key. But here what you have to do is, you have to take the difference. You have to take the difference between ciphertext, we have to take the difference between the numerals of ciphertext and numerals of key. Now, what is the first method? How to get the decrypted message? 7 minus 0? 7 minus 0 is 7, right? 7. 1 minus 1 it is 0. 9 minus 1 it is 8. 9 minus 1 is 8. You have to take the difference between the numerals of ciphertext as well as key. So 7 minus 0 it is 7. 1 minus 1 it is 0. 9 minus 1, it is 8. Now, to get back to our plain text, you need to consider the corresponding alphabets. What is the letter for numeral 7? It is H. these two set of types. So this is sets for 0 disk, E for 8 and I. See here, now before doing encryption of a plain text, the message is high. Now what is being transmitted through Vernum cipher? We have converted this readable message, we have converted this plain text into cipher text via Vernum cipher. So it is in readable format. After modifying this data using Vernum, it becomes non-readable format. In the sense, no one except source and destination, except sender and receiver, no one can able to derive meaningful information from ciphertext. That is the advantage of doing encryption. Now, in order to decrypt the actual message, what we are doing encryption using again Vernum cipher. In decryption, what you are doing, whatever process you followed in encryption, that is getting reversed. Then again, you assign, you consider the letters according to the numbers, you can easily get the plain text. Now you can easily see, before doing encryption, what is the message? Hi. So after doing decryption, what is the message? Hi. So in this way, you can able to transmit any kind of message from one place to another in secure manner using Vernum cipher. Thank you.